In this video, we're gonna do a quick tutorial on an amazing Chrome extension for teachers called Insert Learning. Let's get started. Hey everybody, welcome to Mr. Cook's Corner, Education for Educators. This channel is all about helping teachers grow in their craft. If it's your first time watching, welcome aboard. Please consider subscribing, liking our videos, and sharing this content with your friends. Most teachers already use Chrome extensions on a day-to-day basis to help make their jobs a little bit easier. Today I want to share with you an amazing extension called Insert Learning. And what it does is it allows you to take any website that you can find and turn it into an embeddable resource. You can insert quotes, comments, links, videos. You can post these things on top of the website as it is, and then you can assign it to students for them to go in, read, go through, and then they can check their comprehension through questions and discussion threads. It is a fantastic way to have kids online learn a little bit deeper, and it's great for distance learning as well. Let's take a quick look.
Okay, so the first thing you're gonna wanna do is go to the Chrome Web Store, to the Extension Center, and you're gonna add Insert Learning. I'm gonna drop that link in the description below. Once you've done that, you'll know that you're ready because there's an IL on the top right corner. That means your extension has been added. And then you're just gonna click on Sign Up with Google, and you're gonna connect your Google account. To finish setup, you're just gonna click on Teacher, give your class a name, and now you're at your home page. When you're on the home page, you can search for resources one of two ways. One, you can go to Google and do your normal everyday how you would look for a resource. Or the other way would be to click on the resource button at the top and click on Find Content. You can see here I typed in the search term soccer and it's got plenty of resources for you to look through. However, for most teachers, you probably already have your resource ready to go, so all you have to do is load it up. And in the top right corner, you'll click the extension button for Insert Learning and it'll pop up over on the left-hand side. Let's take a closer look. This first button is just to assign when you're ready. You're gonna do that at the very end. Underneath that is where you highlight your text and you're gonna use this throughout the articles that you're working on. You can insert a sticky note to give information. You can insert a question, multiple choice, short answer, and keep track of students' responses. You can start a discussion. And if you click on the button below, that's more options. And you can do things such as share this with teachers, look at the lesson as a student so you can check to see what you've done. You can print it and you can always get some help and support. So one option that you have, depending on the students that you're working with, is you can highlight important text. So all you do is click on the button, highlight what you want. Then if you choose to, you can hit the plus sign and add a comment to it. When you're done, you click away, it's all set. The purple border tells students that there's a comment there. They'll click on it, it'll pop up. As you can see here, I've gone through the rest of this article and highlighted what I thought may be some important pieces of information, and it helps the students place a focus on each paragraph. One of the coolest features is using the sticky note because you can insert actual videos from other websites. Let me show you how. So for example, a student might not be familiar with rugby. So you can insert a sticky showing a video of rugby being played. All you do is click on insert a sticky note, click on the paragraph where you want to insert it, and then you can type anything in here. So for example, if you wanted to refer them to a rugby page with information, all you would do is copy that and paste it into the sticky note. And when you're done, you have yourself a clickable link. If I want to insert another source, I just click on the sticky button again. This time, let's insert a video. I have a rugby rules explained right here. I'm just going to copy the YouTube link. And you see when you paste it in, the video is actually embedded in the source. So the person can just click on it.
Hello, I'm Ben Kay, and this is Rugby Basics.
To me, that's a game changer. That's some pretty cool stuff right there. The next button that you can use is to insert a question to check for comprehension. You just click on the button, click where you want it, and at the bottom it's gonna ask a question. Now in this case, I typed one out, and all you have to do is hit create when you're done. You even have the choice to turn it into a multiple choice question. You can see I'm just typing and hitting enter, and it gives me all the choices. When you're done, click the right one so you're all set. Another neat thing about inserting a question that I like is that it provides question stems. Here I can do a drop down arrow and it gives me some choices here. Once you've chosen it, again, you just hit create and it's there in the article ready for the students to answer. The next thing I want to show you is how to use the discussion box. It's the same as the other buttons. You click on it, you click on what paragraph you want to do this with, and then you give it a topic question. In this case, I put, why do you think they added a goalie position if the point of the game is not to use your hands? As you can see, as people post their answers, it shows up live and you can keep track of all the different responses. So I'm not going to go through all these extra options, but I do want to show you what happens when you click view as a student. You hit that, it previews it and shows you exactly what a student would see once it's been assigned to them. Everything we've done, all the highlights, all the questions, all the discussions, they're there. It looks great. I'm done previewing. Once you've done that, you're gonna hit the More Options button and hit Go to Dashboard. And as you can see, here's the lesson that you just created.
Before we move on, I want to just remind everybody that we have a link down below in the description to 25 more Chrome extensions for teachers. They're amazing tools for you to use, and if you want to get hooked up, just click on the link in the description below. In the meantime, post a comment and let me know, what is your go-to Chrome extension? What can you not live without? I'd love to share those with you in a future video. All right, let's get back to the action.
So let's cover assigning really quickly. There's just a few steps you have to do to get your class all set up, and it's not hard. It's just like a Google Classroom. You're gonna click on classes, and you're gonna grab the class code. It's just right there. You're gonna copy it, and you're gonna send it out to your students. I recommend you do this through Google Classroom, but if you don't have that, you can just add it whenever you send out the link. When you're ready to assign something, you just click on the big blue assign button, and again, you've got your choices of Google Classroom, Microsoft Teams, or the link. If you're not using Classroom, you would just copy the link to your clipboard and paste it either in an email or however you send out your information to your students. Once they get the link, they just paste it and they hit go, and it takes them to the lesson. You'll notice here though, it's asking them to add it to Chrome. So when students use this, they need to have the extension activated. It's very easy to do. You just have to be in a Chrome browser. So if I'm a student right here and I haven't done it yet, there's a big green button saying add, click on it. You go through the same steps, you add the extension, and you're all set. The lesson is pulled up. But what you'll notice is it's now asking for the class code. Students will just paste the code that you sent with the link. The student is in, and they can go through the lesson as assigned. As you can see, I did the main idea. I answered the question incorrectly, and I added a post to the conversation thread. When you're done, you don't have to submit or turn it in. You're finished. You can close the window. When you're ready to grade the paper, you just come back to your dashboard. You click on grades. You pick the lesson, and you'll see the responses right here. Back in the dashboard again, you can add folders, you can add lessons, you can organize, and you can reuse these as many times as you want.
If you're looking for more resources to keep you going, check out these two videos right here. In the meantime, you can find us all over social media at Mr. Cook's Corner, Instagram, Twitter, TPT, Facebook, we're everywhere. Till then, see you next time. Bye.